Hello everyone. Today we will be learning sense organs and ear. Sense organs. Sensory organs consist of sensory receptors. Receptors are specialized cells or tissue which detect the changes in our own body and in our surrounding. Functions of sense organs. It maintains the homeostasis and they are sensitive to light, sound, smell, touch, and taste. Now, types of receptors. First is mechanoreceptors, the receptors for touch and pressure. They are present in skin. Thermoreceptors, receptors for temperature. They are present in skin again. Photoreceptors, receptors for light, present in retina, that is rods and cones. Chemoreceptors, receptors for chemicals, present in taste buds, olfactory epithelium. And the last is phonoreceptors, receptors for sound, present in internal ear. Now, we are going to discuss here the structure of ear. There are three main parts of ear. First is external ear. Second is middle ear. And the last is internal ear. First is external ear. So, it is the outermost part of the ear which has three main parts. The first is ear pinna. So here you can see this is ear pinna. It is made up of cartilage and covered by the skin. The main function of the ear pinna, it collects the sound waves and directs into the auditory canal. Second is auditory canal. It is little bit curved tube which convey collected sound waves up to the tympanum. And it also secretes ear wax. The function is it prevents the entry of foreign particles and as well as it lubricates the eardrum. The last part of the external ear is tympanum. Tympanum, it is oval, stretched membrane and it vibrates due to the sound waves which sets the ear ossicles into vibration. Second part is middle ear. So this green highlighted part is middle ear. Middle ear consists of irregular air-filled space called tympanic cavity. Tympanic cavity connected with the throat through the Eustachian tube. The main function of the Eustachian tube that it equalizes the pressure on either side of tympanum. Tympanic cavity also has two apertures, that is the oval window and round window. Middle ear contains three tiny bones, that is malleus, incus and stapes, which are collectively called as ear ossicles. Malleus is hammer shaped and attached to the eardrum. Stapes, it is stirrup shaped and attached to the oval window. While incus is anvil shaped and present between malleus and stapes. Function of ear ossicle is that it amplifies the sound waves and transmit it to the oval window. The third and the last part of the ear is internal ear. So, internal ear, here you can see it has two main, here it is the highlighted part is the cochlea and the upper one is the semicircular canal. But together it is called as the membranous labyrinth. Membranous labyrinth is surrounded by an almost similarly shaped bony labyrinth. in between bony and membranous labyrinth. You can see here, so in between the bony labyrinth and membranous labyrinth, a fluid is present which is called as perilym. While membranous labyrinth, it is filled with a fluid called andulym. Membranous labyrinth consists of three parts, that is semicircular canal, investiture, and cochlea. So first is, see the semicircular canal. So these are three in number, which are arranged at right angle to each other in three different planes. So this is the first one, second one, and the third, which is the horizontal. And other two are vertical. The one end of each canal has swollen part, which is called as ampulla. And it contains sensory spot called crista. The crista, it is responsible for dynamic equilibrium. Then the next part is the vestibule. Vestibule, it is a sac-like structure or a bag-like structure. The upper portion is called as the utriculus, while the lower narrow portion is called as the sacculus. Both these contain the sensory spot called macula. And macula is responsible for the static equilibrium. That means when the body is in the static or in a stationary position. And the last part of the internal ear is cochlea. It is a spirally coiled tube having 2.5 coils. It is divided into three horizontal chambers. So here you can see three horizontal chambers, the upper, middle, and the lower chamber. The upper and the lower chamber, the upper and the lower chamber are filled with perilym, and the middle is filled with endolymph. The middle chamber contains the sensory spot called organ of Corti, which helps in hearing. The nerve fibers arising from all sensory spots join to auditory nerve, which carries impulse to the brain. So how do we hear? So pinna collects the sound waves and conduct them into the auditory canal. From the auditory canal, it strikes on the eardrum, and because of that, eardrum vibrates. The vibration of eardrum sets the three ear ossicles into vibration. The vibrating ear ossicles transmit the vibration to the membrane of oval window, which in turn sets the fluid contained in cochlear canal also into vibration. The vibrating movement of the fluid stimulates the hair-like process of sensory spot of cochlea, and that's why the impulses are transmitted to the brain via auditory nerve. So this is all about the structure of ear.